What's up, shorebound flounder heads? Hope you're getting off to a great start. Here's a trip where I culled over a double limit of fluke over 18 inches, all caught on a single quarter ounce jig tipped with a 6-inch jerkshad, the signature technique that I use. As opposed to the previous two trips, the biomass of fluke are on the move. What I typically experience is that once you locate the biomass of fluke, they will tend to stay in the area for no more than 2 weeks. After that, you need to be on your feet to relocate the school. On this trip, I covered about 3 to 4 miles of beach, steadily picking away at quality keepers. All of them, by the way, were safely released. As I mentioned before in a prior video, it really pays to fish both tides in a given day. Think about the rationale behind it. If you have your technique down, if you locate the fluke, it then all comes to deducing the correct conditions that will have the fluke on the feed. If you constantly fish one tide cycle, day after day, you will only get a glimpse of what is happening and miss out on a big opportunity. If you fish both tide cycles and you find which tide produces the bite, the probability of that occurring again the next day under the same condition is almost certain. Enjoy the video and don't forget to subscribe.
Oh yeah. Thank you. Oh.